Not long ago, about the closing in the evening in spring, I sat on the table of a bee coffee house in Aubrey. For months, I had been ill in health, but was now convalescent, and with returning strength, found myself in one of those happy moods which are so precisely the converse of dissatisfaction. At first, my observations took an abstract and generalizing turn. I looked at the passengers in masses and thought of them in their aggregate relations. I began to puzzle the people through their details, pinpointing their figure, dress, air, and expression of countenance to figure them out. For instance, this is a businessman who seems to do whatever it is to get the job done. The cell phone establishes that he is either talking to the wife or is still in the process of finishing his project. Probably an engineer. These individuals I understand as belonging to the race of swell pickpockets with which all great cities are infested. I found it difficult to imagine how they should ever be mistaken for gentlemen by gentlemen themselves. I was occupied in scrutinizing the crowd when suddenly there came into view a countenance which at once arrested and absorbed my whole attention on account of the absolute idiosyncrasy of its expression. I felt singularity aroused, startled, fascinated. Then came a craving desire to keep the man in view, to know more of him. I made my way into the street. With some little difficulty, I at length came within sight of him, approached, and followed him closely, yet cautiously, so as not to attract attention. I caught a glimpse of the dagger. This observation heightened my curiosity, and I resolved to follow the stranger wherever he should go. I was obliged to follow him closely. The street was a narrow and long one, and his course lay within it for nearly an hour, during which the passengers had gradually diminished. As the night deepened, so deepened to me the interest of the scene. At no moment did he see that I watched him. He stared at the windows, spoke no words, and looked at all objects with a wild and vacant stare. I was now utterly amazed at his behavior, and firmly resolved that we should not part until I had satisfaction myself in some measure respecting him. How did he not realize it was me, the one who has been watching him for the last few hours? Steadfastly in the face. He noticed me not. This old man is the type and the genius of deep crime. He refuses to be alone. He is the man of the crowd.